From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. There's new leadership for the main Democratic Party. The party approved Benjamin Grant as its new chairman Sunday afternoon in Augusta at the University of Maine. Grant is a lawyer in Topsom for a firm that deals with labor law and workplace issues. He lives in Portland and has family roots throughout Maine. Grant says he is ready for the job. He also says he's up for the challenge the party faces after November's election that gave Republicans control of both houses of the legislature.
Maine's a state in transition. There's no doubt about it. I think my job is to speak for the 62% of the people who didn't vote for Paula Page for governor, who don't want to see an extreme government, want to see a moderate chart a moderate course that addresses the needs of all people. And I think I speak for the 100% of people who don't want a governor who has his foot in his mouth on a weekly basis.
Grant says the party is committed to working across the aisle when it's appropriate, but also willing to fight for Democratic ideals if they're challenged. The two other candidates for party chair were John Hanson of Bangor and Melissa Sterry of Augusta. In the meantime, Governor Paula Page's supplemental budget, which pays down hospital debts and accounts for increased enrollments in Maine care, now moves into the legislative arena. Monday, the Appropriations Committee is set to take up the revised spending document for the fiscal year ending June 30th. The committee will take up funding for fisheries and wildlife, marine resources, environmental protection, agriculture, and education. Human services spending comes under review Tuesday, and hearings continue through Wednesday. Police in Rumford are looking for the person responsible for a hit and run on Route 2. Officers say Robert McKinnon was walking along the road around 7:45 Saturday night near the intersection of Washington Avenue when he was hit from behind. He was taken to the hospital for treatment and released. Authorities say they're looking for a white Chevy extended cab pickup truck with damage to the front passenger headlight. Lewiston police say they're investigating a drive-by shooting that left one person with minor injuries Saturday night. Officers say they responded to 81 Marble Street around 8 p.m. They say several shots were fired toward a house and at least one went inside. One person had minor injuries to the face. Authorities say it's unknown whether shrapnel, a bullet, or something else caused the injury. Police say they have suspects, but the incident is still under investigation. If any town in Maine knows how to celebrate winter, it's Bethel. Winterfest is now in full swing, a nine-day celebration of the season and the town itself. It is all things winter, a handful of great outdoor and indoor. All activities encompass the very symbol of the event, a giant 100-foot ice tower. Water actually spouts out and Mother Nature does the rest. Neighboring ski resort Mount Abram is also playing a major role with a snowboarding event and street rail jam. Chances are, if you like an outdoor winter activity, there is something for you this week.
It's really designed to bring people out, bring them into town, enjoy some of the activities. We've got Nordic skiing, snowshoeing, downhill alpine skiing. There's ice skating rink here. There's the ice tower to take some pictures of.
Winterfest runs through January 30th. Daily activities are posted on their website. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.